YouTube goers, welcome to another awesome figure review on Toys Collectibles channel. Figure review starting with another awesome figure of Artifacts Collectibles. Wow. Well, I viewed the Stormtroopers yesterday, so feel free to check out that video on that. But where main host is Lord Vader, Darth Vader, Return of Anakin Skywalker. Wow. I gotta say, Artifacts, so badass with their figures, and it's so detailed with this Darth Vader. I really love this figure. I was pretty psyched when I got it, and you know, got for a good price. Actually, good price and a good trade, put as that. But like I was saying, this guy is really badass. So before I start with Darth Vader, the accessories he doesn't come with a lot, but he comes with changeable hands as they did with the other Stormtroopers. So these are his changeable hands. And then there's a good head sculpt of Darth Vader, aka Anakin Skywalker. And the sculpting on here is really nice. It's really detailed. And it's like, wow. Really badass. Really cool. Look at the design on Anakin Skywalker's head at the end of Return of the Jedi when he dies. It's like, wow. Look at the battle scars on his head. It's really awesome what Artifacts does with their figures, aka slash statues. Wow, so cool. It's so detailed, and I love the texture and the black paint on there. Really cool. And you can actually switch the heads off if you want to. You can put the Darth Vader's helmet, or you could put Anakin Skywalker's head on Darth Vader's body. It all depends how you want to display it. And then, as normally, as usual, it comes with a manual kit that shows you how to put Darth Vader together. And then right here on the bottom, like I was saying on the Stormtroopers, on my right hand side, it shows the different poses that you could put Darth Vader in if you want him in a different pose position. So right here shows you how to put them together. And then we got Chinese writing, as you can see right there. Then we got the nice little magnet bend stand for it. So enough with that, let's go to the figure. Now this Darth Vader figure is actually pretty easy to put together and take apart if you ever want like to store him or you don't have no space or anything. He's more easier to put together and take apart than the Stormtroopers put together. Because when I try to take apart the Stormtroopers to change their hands or guns, it's harder to put them apart. So Darth Vader, he's pretty much easier than the Stormtroopers. So I like right here, it's really nice, it's really detailing. I love the reflection of Darth Vader's mask. It's really cool. As you can see like the detailing, the lighting, and you can actually see my reflection a little inside Darth Vader's helmet. So that's really badass. I mean, really cool. And as you can look right here, it got like the nice sculpted detailing. I just love it. It's just wow, it's really badass. And then right here we got Darth Vader's chest piece, nice, you know, glossy glitter blackish going on right here. And then his belt is so detailing. I love how the detailing on his belt is really nice. Really sculpted really good. And it's really nothing really missing out of place. His boots are really nice. Really cool. And then his lightsaber. Let me move the Stormtrooper out of the way. And his lightsaber right here on this left hand. It was pretty hard and tricky to put inside his left hand. Because his lightsaber will get scratched or jammed inside his hand. So what I had to do was open his hand grip a little to stretch out the lightsaber and make it fit in his hand properly without messing it up or scratching it. So what I did was I opened his hand grippily and put the lightsaber in his hand. Now the lightsaber fit loose in his hand, but if you get it in a proper way and tuck it in proper way on his left hand, it will be nice and gripped on his left hand. And his cape is really hard to like stay in place, because when you move his head a little, his head will like make the cape pop off, and the cape pops off very easy. And in my opinion, I feel like the cape should, at least, stay in place, like when you put it in, like a snap in. So yeah, but what sucks about this, doesn't have no flexibility, doesn't have no ab crunch, no elbow joints or knee joints, like I was saying about the stormtroopers. The only thing it does have is a head swivel. So I mean, the head does turn right and left. So on the other hand, it's still a good figure, you guys. I mean, I love this figure. Wow, so nice. It's like, look at the detailing on the back, turning it from right here. So this figure is actually taller than the stormtroopers. I believe this figure is 8 inches taller than the two stormtroopers put together on the side, because I did a measurement on them before I was going to do the video. So the stormtroopers stand for 5 feet, not 5 feet, but excuse me, 5 inches tall. So that's not bad. It's close to a 6-inch figure size. So Darth Vader's a little taller than them. So as normally the Darth Vader comes with is a simple base of a stand. So nothing really too crazy. And like I was saying before, on the bottom of his feet he gets magnetized, so you could put his feet right onto the platform right there, and his feet will automatically go in. So like if you guys want to shelf him or anyway, you could put him on that. Or normally you could put the stance middle plate stands on there if you wanted to. So yeah, but that's a good collection. My rating for this Darth Vader is 10 out of 10. This is really, they really did a good job. Artifacts, man, you know what? This is, I don't have nothing else to say about this figure besides it being awesome. It's a great collectible figure. It's great for your collection, and it's something you must have. And they're coming out with more pretty soon, hopefully. And I'd love to get my hands on some more. But anyways, YouTube goers, that was my figure review on Toys Collectibles channel figure review. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you enjoyed the figures. Please subscribe to my channel. Please check out my other videos, and please be a part of my fan page on Facebook at Toys Collectibles channel. You go to search engine on Facebook, type in Toys Collectibles channel, you press like, and you share my page with others. You guys will be updated with photos and other great news. Anyways, guys, before I go, this coming weekend on Saturday and Sunday, for all the Bay Area people, there is a toy show going on in Ceremony this Saturday and Sunday. So I hope to see you guys there, and hope to find great more figures and great more stuff to review. But anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you on the next. Peace. I find your lack of faith disturbing. Join the dark side, YouTube goers. It's your destiny.